Dear students, welcome to Divya's Math Solutions. Today we are going to discuss Chapter 7 Triangles, Exercise 7.1. So in this triangles, we already learned the congruency in the chapter, in class 7, right? That means what is a congruency? Means the two angles or two side, all the sides or angles, if everything is equal in two triangles that are equal, means what we can say that two triangles are congruent. That means what are the congruency rules? SAS means side angle side, SSS side, AA angle. So like that RHS is also there, right? So based on that, here also we are going to simplify this one. So we learned some congruency rules. So based on that, here we are going to simplify. So if you prove that two triangles are congruency, means we need to write some steps, right? That means equal sides or equal angles we need to write. Then we can prove that these two triangles are congruent. Once it is congruent, means then by CPCT. CPCT means what? Corresponding parts of the congruent triangles are equal. So some sides or angles we need to prove, means by CPCT we can write that are equal also. Anyway, first question number 1. In quadrilateral ABCD, AC equal to AD and AB bisect angle A. AB is bisecting angle A. Angle A means this is a full angle is A, right? This AB is bisecting. Bisecting means cut into two equal parts. That means this much of angles is equal to this much. These two angles are equal only. If this is X, means this is also X. That is the meaning is bisecting. Angle A means the full angle. The CAD is the angle A. So AB is the bisector, means that angle is cut into two equal parts. If it is 50, means 25, 25 each. If it is 60, means 30, 30 each, right? That is the meaning of bisect. So we need to show that triangle ABC is similar to triangle ABD. So in order to prove, means first we need to write in triangle ABC and triangle ABD. Step by step we need to write. So we are selecting two triangles as ABC and ABD. Then we are going to write what are the parts are equal, it is given or not. Okay, what is given? AC equal to AD is given, right? That is the first step. AC equal to AD. So when we are writing the steps, means the reason also you should mention. What is the reason? It is given, right? The reason is given. So AC equal to AD, that is given. Again, it is given AB bisect angle A. That means which one? Angle CAB equal to angle BAD. Both are equal only, right? So we can write angle CAB equal to angle BAD. Angle BAD. CAB or BAC. Anyway, the angle A should come in the middle. That's all. This one BAD or DAB also we can write. The angle A should come in the middle. That's all. This is equal. So what is the reason for this one? That means AB bisect angle A. That is the reason. AB bisect angle A. That is the reason for these two angles are equal. Now we have one side. In both triangles, sides are equal, angles are equal. Then which one? This AB is common to both the triangle ABC and ABD. That means AB equal to AB. AB equal to B means what is the reason? Common. Correct. That means two sides and one angle. Then based on the order only we can select. This is SAS or SSA. Like that we need to select, means what we need to check? We need to check the order. That means this is a side, this is the angle, this is the another side we are taking, common side. That means S, A, S. In this triangle also, S, A, S. We should, when you are writing the congruency rule, means we should make sure from the figure. This is order is correct or not. Okay. So what we can write? Therefore, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle ABD. So what is the reason? SAS congruency rule. The reason is SAS congruency rule. This is the reason. So it is clear. This is proved only. This one only we need to show that, right? That means this one is proved. That is the first part. So when you are writing this one, you should, one more thing, you should make sure that the order is correct. Then AC equal to AD. AC equal to AD, correct. Then angle A equal to angle A. AB equal to AB. Here no need to check because it is given sure that. If it is not sure that means you should make sure that you are writing the same order for congruency of the triangle. Okay. Next part is what you can say about BC and BD. That means BC and BD are what? This is BC, this is BD. That two are the sides. When two triangles are similar means what we can say? Corresponding sides are equal, corresponding angles are equal. Like that we can say, right? So here we can check BC. BC means the last two letters. Here what is the two letter corresponding to that one? BD. So from here we can write BC is equal to BD. That's why I am telling we need to write in the proper order while you are writing the congruency. So here we can write BC equal to BD. BC equal to BD directly we can write. Only we should mention the reason. What is the reason? CP, CTC. That means corresponding parts of the congruent triangles are equal. CP, CTC we can write. Question number 2. ABCD is a quadrilateral in which AD equal to BC, angle DAB. Angle DAB equal to angle CBA. Okay. Next, here first we need to prove triangle ABD is congruent to triangle BAC. ABD. This one. ABD is this triangle and BAC. BAC is this triangle, right? This is a triangle. So we can write, for first one we can write, in triangle ABD and triangle BAC. To prove the congruency, this is the first step. We need to select two triangles. That is the first step. Then we are going to write the statements to prove that two triangles are congruent. So what is given? Here it is given AD equal to BC. AD equal to BC. AD is a part of first triangle. BC is a part of second triangle. Right. So here we can write AD equal to BC. What is the reason given? The reason is given. Next day, DAB. DAB and CBA. That is also part of this triangle only. Right. That means angle DAB equal to angle CBA. What is the reason? That is also given. But only we have two statements. One side and one angle. So we need to find something else. Then only we can say that these two triangles are congruent. Right. So we can check. This is, what is the first triangle? ABD. This is a triangle. Right. ABD is a triangle. Next BAC. That means this AB is common to both the triangles. Right. So this is the ABD. ABD is the first triangle we are selecting. And second triangle is this BAC. So which one is common to both the triangles? This side AB is common. Right. So we can write AB equal to AB. So what is the reason? Common. So now we can write, therefore, triangle ABD is congruent to triangle BAC. What is the reason? We can verify this one, this side also. That means side, angle, side. Here also, side, angle, side. Again, SAS, congruency rule, these two triangles are congruent. Then second part. Second part we need to prove BD equal to AC. That means if two triangles are congruent means corresponding angles and corresponding sides are equal only, right? So from here we can write BD. BD equal to AC. So directly we can write BD equal to AC. Reason, corresponding parts of the congruent triangles are equal. That statement we need to write. One, we need to show that these two angles are equal. ABD, BAC. So directly also that one also we can write. Angle ABD equal to angle BAC. The order is same. What is the reason? Corresponding parts of the congruent triangles are equal. We can write. CP, CTC we can write. Reason. Question number 3. AD and BC are equal perpendicular to a line segment AB. Show that CD bisect AB. So we need to prove this CD is bisecting AB. This is a CD. Bisecting means cut into two equal parts, right? So this CD is bisecting AB on which point? O, right? That means the AB means the AO equal to BO only we are going to prove. What we need to prove? AO equal to BO. So that is the meaning of CD bisect AB. Bisecting AB means AB is cut into two equal parts. That means AO equal to BO we are going to prove. Correct. So this AO and BO are part of triangle AOD and BOC, right? So we can select that two triangles. In triangle BOC and triangle AOD, these two triangles only we are taking. If two triangles are congruent, means what we can say, corresponding parts are equal. So from there we can prove this AO equal to BO, correct? Then it is given AD and BC are equal perpendicular to the line segment AB. This is perpendicular only, that means 90 degree, correct? So these two angles are 90, we can write, that means angle OBC, angle OBC equal to angle OAD. OAD, the reason is 90 degree each. 90 degree each, right? That means these two angles are 90, perpendicular means 90 degree only, right? That means this angle B equal to angle A equal to 90 degree. Next, here we can see that these two angles are vertically opposite, right? This angle is vertically opposite to this one. How we can say vertically? If two lines are intersecting each other, means these two are the vertically opposite angles and this one are vertically opposite angles. Here CD and AB are intersecting each other at O. So these two are, we can take it as vertically opposite angles. That means angle BOC equal to angle AOD. What is the reason? Vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. Now we have two angles. Then it is given AD and BC are equal perpendicular to a line segment, right? That means AD and BC are equal is also given. So what we can write? AD equal to BC. That is also given. Correct. So from here, what we can write? This one angle. This is angle. This is angle. This is side. So again, angle, angle, side. AAS congruency we can write. So therefore, triangle BOC is congruent to triangle. The order we should write in the same way, because here it is not given the congruency in the question. So we are only writing. So that time we need to make sure the order is correct or not. Then BOC, that means this O is corresponding to O. That means O should come in the middle. Next, AD equal to BC. BC, that means A and D should come first, last. So that is correct only, that means AOD. The angle B equal to angle A, angle O is equal to angle O, AD, AD equal to BC, correct. So these two triangles are congruent by AAS congruency rule. So if two triangles are congruent, means what we can write? Corresponding parts are equal, right? That means AO equal to, here this is AO, this is BO, right? So from here what we can write? BO equal to AO, that means AO equal to BO only, right? So from here what we can write? The CD bisect, therefore CD bisect AB. So reason is CP CT, corresponding parts of congruent triangles are equal. Question number 4. L and M are two parallel lines. Here L and M are two parallel lines intersected by another pair of lines P and Q. So this L and M parallel lines intersected by P and Q. This P is parallel to Q. This L is parallel to M also. Then show that triangle ABC. ABC is congruent to CDA. This one only we are going to prove. Correct. So we can select that two triangles. Triangle ABC and in triangle ABC and triangle CDA. These two triangles we are taking. Next, what we can say about the angles? This is the one triangle, this is another triangle. Then two lines are parallel means alternate angles are equal we can take, right? So this is, suppose I am taking this angle, means that is alternative to which one? This BC, no. Angle BAC is corresponding to this angle, right? That means angle ACD. These two are corresponding angles. This PQ, let me draw. This is a P line. This is a Q line. This is AC. So I'm taking this angle means this angle is alternative to this one. This is a alternate angles, right? That means this angle we can name it as angle BAC. Angle BAC equal to this angle is angle ACD, correct? Angle ACD. Reason is alternate angles. Next, in this triangle, this AC is common, right? AC is common to both the triangles. So, we can write AC equal to AC. Reason common. Now, we have two angles and, one triangle and one side, right? Then, what we can take? So, again, suppose this angle I am taking means this one is alternate to which one? This one. Again, we can take alternate angles, correct? That means, here, this angle is alternate to this one. So, this one we can name it as BCA. Angle BCA equal to, this one is alternate to this one. That is angle DAC. Angle DAC. What is the reason? Alternate angles. So, this one again. If you are considering this triangle ABC means angle, side, angle. This is not AAS. AAS means what? Angle, angle, side. Correct. So, the order also we should check this one. Angle. This is also angle. This is side. Then here the side is included between two angles. So, included between two sides means what? AAS only. Right. If it is side is two angles, then one side means that is AAS. Here the side is included. So, we should, when we mark these all things means we can check. This is angle, then side, then angle. Here also angle, side, angle. This is not AAS form. So, we can write therefore triangle ABC is congruent to triangle CDA. So, what is the reason? ASA congruency. That only we need to prove. Answer.